Hello and welcome back to the second part of this video series on animating Genesis figure from Daz Studio in Blender using Rig-GNS. In the previous lesson, we covered the process of importing these figures from Daz Studio to Blender. Now, in this segment, we're going to look at how we can animate these figures with the Animix setup. Let us start by adding a floor to our scene. First, make sure you have the cursor at the center of the scene. You can do this by pressing Shift S and selecting Cursor to World Origin. Now press Shift A and add a plane. I'm going to scale it up to the desired size. I'll go ahead and delete that. Now I'll select the male rig and then the female rig. Press 1 to switch to front view. Then press the period key to have the viewport focused on these two characters. Now to position the camera to my current view, I will hold down Ctrl, Alt and then press 0 on the numpad. Animating characters require a clear understanding of your storyline, and in my case, I plan on animating a fight scene. So my goal is to make these two characters walk into the camera view, then assume fight poses, engage in a brief dialogue, and then they start fighting. Now to achieve this, I will need to have these two characters face each other. So I will start with this male rig, rotate it in object mode. Oh, I'm already in object mode. So I will simply press R and rotate these 90 degrees on the Z-axis. Press the minus key to invert that. And let me collapse this option so it doesn't obscure the screencast keys. Now I'll rotate this female rig on the Z-axis as well. Okay, now I'll go to camera view and then move this figure outside of the camera's view along the X-axis. And let me quickly change the transform orientation to global. Now I will also select this male character and move it outside of the camera view as well. Before I begin importing the animations that will be used to animate these figures, one more thing I will need to do is go to viewport shading up here and add shadow to the scene. And I also prefer having this color set to random. The reason for adding shadows is it gives a better understanding of the foot placement on the floor. For instance, thanks to the shadow, we can see that this character is not entirely on the floor, so shadow can be quite helpful in this regard. Now to the exciting part, which is importing animations. I'll be using Mixamo Animation in this lesson because they offer a wide selection of free options. Now to import animations, I'll go to the Animixer tab and click Get to reveal these options and then select Get Mixamo, and this automatically opens up my web browser. Alright, I already have Mixamo opened on another tab, so I'll just go ahead and close this. So as I mentioned, I'm going to animate a fight scene, and I said I want the characters to walk into view and then transition into a combat pose. So now I'll search for a walking animation. But before I do that, it is important to note that when using Mixamo Animation with Rig-GNS, make sure to have the preview character set to export. You will notice the preview character used for this animation is different. This is called Whiteboard. So if you have this or any other character as the preview character, then you will need to change it to export by going to the characters tab here where you will find various characters. And if this export is not your current preview character, simply search for export here and set it as the preview character. Only then will the animation work without issues in Blender. Now let's go back to the animations and search for walk animation. I think I'm going with this walk animation. In the preview window, we can see the walk animation. Down here is the option to have the character in place. Now, depending on your preference, you might choose to use the animation with or without the progress. But I personally prefer using the progressive animation because Genesis figures and the export figure here in Mixamo have similar heights, hence having similar strides. And this results in little to no foot sliding when used in Blender, which is why I almost always leave this box unchecked. But for the purpose of demonstration, in case your character's stride differs from that of Mixamo, I will enable the in place option and then proceed to download this animation. Now, in the download settings, I will choose without skin, keep the format as FBX binary, set the frame rate to 30 FPS, and then click download. Alright, now with the animation downloaded, I will head back to Blender, go to the Animixer tab, and click import motion. Select import Mixamo. I have the animation in my downloads folder, working, select it, and then click import Mixamo FBX. Alright, Now, to bind this imported amateur to any of these characters, you will need to have the targeted character as the active selection and then click bind. Now you can see the animation is bound to this figure, so I'll press play to preview it. I'm not getting the speed I was hoping for, so to improve performance and ensure the animation plays smoothly without lag, I will hide some of the objects that mix up the character's clothing. I will select this hair object as well. Also select the bodysuit of the male character and then press M to move these items to a different collection. I will select new collection, rename it cloth, and click OK. In the view layer, I will go to cloth collection and then click this box to disable it. And we are getting 23 FPS, which is much better. Let me also include some of these items to the cloth collection. Okay. Here in the output panel, you can see that our frame rate is at 30 FPS and the animation speed is also clocking 30 FPS. Alright. As I mentioned earlier, this is the working animation from Mixamo, and you can see the character is moving in place. However, we have an option to turn it into a progressive animation. And to do that, first select the character's rig. Let me enlarge the panel so we have a clearer view. Now in the Animixer tab, you will find this foot slide button. Click and drag it up to create a progressive walk animation until any sliding of the foot is completely eliminated. I am happy with this adjustment, so I will click again, and now we have a progressive walk animation. Alright. So now when I switch to camera view, we shall see the female character walking into view. To have the animation embedded to this rig, you will need to click the big button here. But before baking the animation, it is good practice to review the animation. Pay attention to any adjustments that might be needed, particularly in the limbs. This could involve correcting the shoulder position, arm angles, or thigh width if necessary. You have the flexibility to adjust the animation here, where it says adjust. All you need to do is click to select the bone you want to adjust from this list. Let's select head, so you can go ahead and make the adjustment on any of these axes. For example, when I select x-axis, I will then click the tilt button to tilt the head on the x-axis. The same applies to z-axis or y-axis. You can make the adjustment on any of these bones. Let us try it again on the thigh. Tilt it on the y-axis, the z-axis, or the x-axis. I'm using the right mouse click to cancel the adjustment since I am satisfied with the animation and wouldn't be needing any adjustment. The left mouse click should be used to confirm any adjustment. Now I'll proceed to click bake, and in this pop-up box that appears, I can decide the range of frames I want to bake. I will go ahead with the full range from 1 to 30 and then click OK. As soon as the baking process is complete, the animation will appear in the baked action panel down here. There's the animation. Now I'll press play and then return to camera view. It appears I will still need the character to walk a bit further into the frame around this point, but the animation ended at frame 30, but the character has barely walked into the frame and I want the character somewhere close to the center. Now, one way to extend the animation to make the character closer to the center is by using the NLA editor. Now, I'm going to split the screen and switch this to NLA editor. Let me set the frame to 1 and let us first return to the Rig-GNS panel. When you have an action assigned to a character, you can push it down to the NLA timeline as a strip using this pushdown button. Now, when I remove the action, the pushdown option disappears. To reassign the action, click on the baked action icon here, select an action, and now you can push it down as a strip in the NLA timeline. Now, let us make the animation longer by pressing Shift D to duplicate the strip in the NLA and then moving it to the end of the first strip. Now, click the Match Frame button in the Rig-GNS panel to ensure the frame range matches the length of the animation. Now we have a longer working animation. However, you will notice that when the playhead exits the first strip and starts on the second strip, the character reverts to the starting position. To fix this issue, we can use the option called the Align NLA Strip. Now, to use the option, first select the later strip, and then while holding down Shift, select the former strip to have both selected. This basically tells the addon you want to align the later strip to this one. Now, when I click the Align Strip button, you will notice it moves the character forward. Essentially, what it did was make the starting position of the character in the later strip begin where the former strip ended. So now, if I take the playhead back and play the animation, you can see there is a progress in the animation. Now we have the figure moving further into the scene. Alright, the next thing now is to have the character come to a stop after walking into view. So let us go back to the web browser. Still on the Mixamo page, I am going to search for walk stop. I will select this female stop walking animation. It appears we don't have the in place option for this animation, so not all animations have the in place option. This animation should work, but let me quickly check if there are other options. Here's another one, but I will just go with the one I have. So I will click download, and with the same settings as before, I will download the animation. Okay, with that downloaded, I'll go back to Blender and then go to import motion, Mixamo, female stop walk, and import that. Now I'm going to click bind. Oh, sorry, I forgot to point out something. So let me undo that. So before binding new animations to the character, especially animations you intend to blend with existing animation, it is good practice to first evaluate the current animation. This helps give an understanding of how well the animation can be smoothly integrated with the existing one. Now, I will scrub through the timeline to carefully examine this existing working animation strip. You want to pay close attention to the placement of the character's feet. Here, for instance, the right foot is planted firmly on the ground while the left foot is in mid-swing. Just as the left foot is about to pass the right foot, the animation ends. Understanding these details is crucial for creating a seamless transition between animations. Now, keep in mind that in the last frame of this current strip, the right foot is planted on the ground and the left foot is in the air. Now, as I proceed to bind the imported animation to the figure, it is crucial to ensure that the new animation begins with the right foot planted on the ground so that it aligns with the end of the working animation. Let me demonstrate this by scrubbing through the timeline. Mind you, the animation we are currently viewing is not from the NLA strip. The Mixamo animation we just bound to the figure is what we are seeing. It is currently overshadowing the strip. So now, as I examine the beginning of the new animation, we can see that the left foot is planted on the ground instead of the right foot. Now, to have the right foot on the ground, I will go to the Rig-GNS panel and then click the mirror button here. And we should immediately see that the right foot is planted on the ground and the left foot is in mid-air. So now, with that done, I can now proceed to bake the animation using the bake button. I will select the full range from 1 to 47 and click OK. Once the baking process is completed, you will see the animation listed in the baked action panel. Now, in the NLA editor, I will click the push down button to add the female stop walking animation as a strip. Then I will select the strip and then drag it to the tail end of the previous strip. Now, when I scrub through the timeline, you can see nothing is happening. Even when I press play, let me quickly make the frame range match the length of the animation. So now when I play the animation, you can see nothing really happens until the playhead gets to this new strip. The reason for this is because there is an extrapolation option in the properties panel set to hold. And to resolve this, you need to have it set as nothing. Now, going back to the frames before the last strip, you will see that the animation now plays on both the old strip and the newly added strip. An alternative approach I prefer is to leave the extrapolation option as hold and use this blend in option instead. When the extrapolation is set as hold and blend in is 0, nothing happens in the previous strip. However, by adjusting it slightly to 0.1, you can see it eliminates the freezing and make both the old animation and the new animation play. You should know that in the NLA editor, the animation strip above takes priority over the one below, much like how it works in Adobe Premiere Pro. Okay, Now, when I preview the animation by scrubbing through the timeline, you will see that immediately the playhead transitioned from the previous trip to the new one, the character snaps to its starting position. Now, to ensure a seamless animation, we can of course use the align NLA strip. Remember, to make this work, you need to select the new strip first and then hold down shift and select the previous strip. And after that, you can click the align NLA strip button. Now, when I press play, you will notice how the animation continues from the old strip to the new one. To fine-tune the blending, select the strip and adjust the blending option to say 5 frames. Also, slightly shifting the strip back and forth can also improve the results. Feel free to experiment with the blend-in values until you achieve the desired outcome. Now will be a great moment to subscribe to the channel if you haven't, because I can tell you are enjoying this lesson. So thank you in advance for your support. Alright. To avoid making this video too lengthy, I will add one more animation to transition the character into a fight pose. So back to my browser. I will search for Fight Idol. Here we have Standing to Fight Idol, which is what I'm looking for. I will now go ahead and select it and then download. Back in Blender, I will go ahead and import the animation Standing Idol to Fight. Click the bind button. Hit play to preview it and then proceed to bake the animation. With the baked animation assigned to the character, in the NLA editor, I will push down the action, select the new strip, move it to the end of the existing strips, and then click the match frame button. I personally prefer stacking the new strip above the track of the last one. It might not be a conventional method, but I find it to suit my workflow better. Now, I won't be able to move this strip above this one because we currently don't have a track above it, so it's stuck on the same track with this top working strip. Now, to place this strip on a separate track above the last one, we'll first need to add a new track. So to do this, go to add and select add tracks. And now we can move this strip above the last one. Again, nothing is happening when I scrub through the timeline. To resolve this, select the new strip and increase the blending value slightly. This will allow us to transition from the previous strip to the new one. And to prevent the character from snapping to the starting position of the animation, select the new strip, hold down shift, select the last strip, and click the align NLA strip button. Yeah, so this ensures a smooth transition into the fight pose. You can again fine-tune the animation with the blending values. Okay, now let us preview the entire animation we've created so far. Go back to frame 1, switch to camera view, turn off overlays, and then hit play. Alright, so that concludes this part of the tutorial. In the next segment, we will look at the functions of some of the buttons in the Animixer tab that we haven't covered. So if you found this video helpful, please give it a like. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.